dicen por ahí que estoy más bien un poco loca, que tengo lo que quiero y todo lo que me provoca, sin pensar lo que hay dentro de mí, pues ya ven, yo soy así. Simplemente quiero y vivo para poder ser feliz. Dicen por ahí que estoy bien un poco loca y que sueño con llegar a ser tu esposa. Tengo la seguridad de poderles demostrar que soy la gran actriz, pero también soy la mujer, que soy la madre fiel, siempre la...
Regular AR 181 con destino al aeropuerto Ezeiza Ministro Pistarini de la ciudad de Buenos Aires. El tiempo de vuelo hacia Buenos Aires ha sido estimado en 13 horas y 10 minutos y la altura de crucero 9.600 metros. Le solicitamos ajustar los cinturones de seguridad, trabar las mesas rebatibles, colocar los respaldos de sus asientos en posición vertical, levantar los apoyapiés y mantener los pasillos despejados.
Okay, we're on board flight Aerolineas Argentinas 1181. We're just coming after about 10 hours of isolation flying over the ocean. We're just over land right now at waypoint Satin, S-A-T-I-N. And this is the first sighting of the land after 10 hours of overnight crossing on the Pacific. We're at 38,500 feet.
Very enthusiastic.
Congratulations.
Our engineer department of Aerolineas Argentinas many years ago developed these special routes that then another airlines like Lanchile or Qantas or whatever started to use, like Shepson did all around the world, for example. And we made this Transpolar routes.
See.
Si. We created this in the 1980, that is why the name, the number of the flying, 1180, the inbound flight. And we were the first airliner all around the world to make this kind of flight and these so big latitudes. And Buenos Aires, Sydney, is the longest fly ever made for any airliner. The inbound flight, due to the winds, depends, arrives up to 16 hours and 45 minutes. Fly time, not block. Just when you take off until...
Would you need a refill in Ushuaia or in Rio Gallegos?
No.
Or you think you can go non-stop in very strong headwind condition?
The most worst condition for us lead us to a flight of 16 hours and 45 minutes, which is a lot, my friend. It's a lot.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable, non-stop flying. And we have almost 13 and a half, 13. It is New Zealand, Australia is here.
Yes.
13 and a half flying over nothing.
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 And you don't call on radio. Do you call to Antarctica and Murdo?
Yes.
You have to communicate.
No, we communicate with Auckland Oceanic by HF and Santiago, Chile Oceanic by HF. We are out of communication since 1.5 hours because we cannot read.
So how long was the last communication?
Oh, the last communication was Auckland Control.
And now we are
in the latitude.
We have communication with
in the longitude one
to the control. This is similar position and the flight level because we are
3-5.
Yes, in block flight. Yeah.
Because we cannot contact via HF.
Yeah.
We use the ACAR systems to communicate with our base in Argentina, and they will retransmit the communication to the Oceanic Control of Chile.
Sí.
Okay? Sometimes we used to communicate by HF with an Antarctica base, not McMurdo, but an Argentinian base called Marambio.
Marambio.
Marambio, yes. Maybe you Google it and you will find it out. It's an Antarctica base, just to say hello, we are here and we are okay.
So Argentina has a territory in Antarctica?
Yes. That's
a huge
territory in Antarctica, this peninsula more or less, with several bases, Navy bases, Air Force bases and Army bases.
So would that be your alternative if anything happened? Could you land in this Argentinian station?
No, because the airports are not appropriate to land these planes.
No.
Anyway, we are far away from it.
Yeah.
We are about 2,500 kilometers or 1,500 miles from the South Pole. We are far away from everywhere.
How far south in latitude you think this route goes? I heard it says as far as 71 degrees south.
Exactly, but it's not in this map. Yes, here you can see in this map up to 72 degrees of latitude. You see?
Yes.
So how many sets of standard published routes you can choose? During, I guess it's up to the wind condition.
It's up to the wind condition.
Would you use 72 often or no? Not often.
Yes.
You would use that often as well.
It's due to the wind condition, absolutely. But we face another problem that we are not contemplated in the manufacture of the aircraft. Flying at these latitudes, we have big frozen point of the fuel.
Yes.
And the aircraft is on its limit. Sometimes we face the problem of to have the, I will put you the page of the fuel management system here. Sometimes we arrive to the point where we reach the freezing point of the fuel in the outer tanks. These one are the outer tanks.
Yes.
The system, and sometimes we suffer the problem of the freezing point of the fuel, which is risky a lot.
Right.
Sorry for my English, it's not so good, but
no,
maybe
it's perfect.
It's good an idea for you to understand. And well, sometimes we have the alarms regarding the telling us that the fuel is going to be freeze.
Yes.
In a moment, and we have to perform different actions.
What actions do you need to take?
Okay, well, the first action is to transfer the fuel from the outer tanks to the inner tanks, where we have a heater interchange, and we can heat a little bit the fuel. If this is not enough, we must absolutely go down to a warmer atmosphere.
To what extent, you think, to lower than 30,000?
Minimum, we have to go down minimum 10,000 feet in order to reach a warmer atmosphere.
Does this happening quite regularly?
Well, what happened to me was to reach the freezing point and to have the need to go down 10 levels, 10,000 feet down.
Yeah.
But in the worst, you must turn northbound.
Northbound
in order to leave the frozen latitudes.
So this will add more flight time.
It will lead you to more flight times, and you have to make a decision whether to continue the flight to the final destination, that in case is Sydney, or to go to your alternate. That we have only one alternate, Auckland.
You don't go to Christchurch.
Christchurch. Yeah. If it is operative. But Christchurch has another limitation. If Christchurch is under fog with bad visibility condition, they don't have the capability to have category 3 landing. So the only one airport
no category 3
with cat 3 is open. Yeah.
I see.
770, close to Lassie.
Yeah.
54 South 80. Should be, where is it?
Yeah.
Here.
Okay.
This road. 5770.
Yeah.
5960. Made this road. Here. And we are going to Bariloche and Balmaceda, Chile, and Bariloche, Argentina. This route.
So, what's the southern? What's the most south waypoints we have?
In this route,
through we have 54?
60
south.
60 latitude. And we fly this latitude for 1, 2, 3, 4 waypoints.
4 waypoints.
Going to have nice scenarios of the southern Patagonia between the Chilean and Argentinian Patagonia.